Hello, viewers of Wasteland TV. We are here with
Mark Dodson.
What has Mark Dodson done?
What is what?
Mark Dodson.
It's hard for me to hear with the
with
music
all the rock
going.
And roll music.
We're rocking out, and Mark Dodson likes to rock and roll. But also, I've done Gremlins. I did the movie Gremlins. I'm the voice of the Gremlins.
Did you do Gremlins 2?
I did Gremlins 2. I'm Daffy, Lenny, George, and a whole bunch of the other Gremlins.
How about Gremlins 1?
Huh?
Which one did you do in Gremlins 1?
Gremlins 1, it's easier to tell you who I didn't do. I didn't do Stripe and I didn't do Gizmo. That's Frank Welker and Howie Mandel. I'm the majority of all the rest of the Gremlins in Gremlins 1. And yeah, everybody from the fan Gremlin to the caroling Gremlins to the Gremlins in the theater to the Gremlin on Santa Claus to the one hanging in from the Christmas lights. I'm almost all of them. The bar scene. Yeah. And then also I did, I'm looking over at my table. Salacious Crumb for Return of the Jedi. I did Zombies for Day of the Dead with George Romero. Voices, of course. I'm the voices.
Huh.
So I'm all the voice stuff. Yeah.
So which other movies have you done voices for?
Oh my gosh, I did a TV special called The Ewoks Battle for Endor. I'm Teek, and some of the giants in that, they're called Marauders. I did Force Awakens. I did some of the background stormtroopers, voices. This guy right here, who's in Maz Kanata's castle, his name is Cretinus. I did his voice. Lots of background stuff in that movie. Oh gosh, I narrate for Outdoor Channel, History Channel.
Have you done any cartoons?
I did some stuff. I did a lot of background on a show called Bonkers. I was Professor Moliarty's Hinch Moles in Darkwing Duck. I was Darkwing Duck's guard dog that barks in every episode. Can't even remember everything I've done. I mean, stuff for Chuck E. Cheese. They did some animation. I've done Disney. I did a show called Fitness and Me. I did Disney Records. I could go on and on. It's going to get boring if I just sit here and name. There's been hundreds and hundreds of things. So I've been at it for 40 years.
So you're like the old timer.
And I'm still, yes, I'm an old timer.
Jack of all trades, not just focus on one voice.
No, I don't. I do everything. I mean, I do promos, trailers, narrations, characters, industrials, you know, yeah.
So which one was your favorite to do?
I mean, they're all different. Like now I do a lot of video games work. Salacious Crumb is my favorite because that was my beginning. And I was at Lucasfilm, you know, full-time, in-house. So there's a lot of memories that go with Salacious.
Plus.
And then Gremlins, of course, came a year after, and that was just a lot of fun to be a part of.
To have two occult classics back-to-back, basically.
Yeah, it's kind of, I was lucky, right? I mean, cult classics, Jedi, Gremlins, Day of the Dead, one year right after another.
And then
they've all become cult classics.
One that's a true cult classic is Gremlins 2.
And Gremlins 2.
A lot of people actually say it's better than Gremlins 1 now.
Yeah. That, you know, I love Gremlins too. I'm Daffy in that. There's Daffy as a gremlin and a Mugwai. So I love Daffy. Daffy was fun. He's a fun gremlin. He's a fun Mugwai.
Did you ever get any of those Mugwais, like the puppets you get?
I actually got a gremlin from Gremlins 2.
Is it still in good condition?
Yeah. Very good.
I've seen some puppets and they're just deteriorating.
Yeah, no, I kept mine wrapped in plastic and in a footlocker. So it's like just like brand new.
So you didn't have it out on the table to display?
I never did display it.
So did you get that one from Mezik?
No, this is a replica And it's from a company called Trick or Treat Studios. You can order these online. They're about $250.
Wow.
From Trick or Treat Studios. But they're worth it. I mean, they're really well made. They're rubber. You know, you can put your hand in there and move his mouth.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, they're cool. And they got different ones now too.
They make any other ones you did?
Yeah. I mean, that's, you know, one of the from Gremlins 1.
Ah. Not so, from Gremlins 2 yet?
No, I think I heard they're making a Daffy, but I could be wrong.
Daffy's been made as a Mezik figure. I've seen it at Target.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. But I mean, not a life size. Somebody's getting ready to do a life size Daffy, which would be about that size.
But they'll probably have rotated eyes.
And his eyes will probably spin, and yeah, that'd be cool.
And that's one of his.
And I want to get one. If they make one, I definitely want one of those.
You'll probably have to get two, one to keep in box.
And one to keep and one to, take on the road.
The old collector's thing.
Right. Well, it's nice when I do shows. So I drove to this show. When I drive to shows, I'll bring a Gremlin with me or, you know, something like this. But when I fly, I don't bring them with me. It'd be too much.
Yeah.
Kind of
when
an
you
hassle.
Fly, when you drive, you can put them hanging out of the window.
Yeah, when I drive, I can, have him hang out the
window. And then people.
I don't do that. But he's in my car with me.
You can then get into the lane where you can have two people.
Oh, right. I got a Gremlin. Yeah, the diamond lane.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, the diamond lane, or what is that? Well, where you got to have two people in the car.
Yeah, I forget what it's called either. I just know that certain times of the day, you got to have
California, that's a California thing.
Is it really?
Yeah, and it's an extra lane, everybody, and there's a diamond painted every many feet in the lane. That's the diamond lane. And it's for commuters, really, during commute time. You got to have two people in the car at least. So, yeah.
I know people have tried to use blow-up dolls to get it.
Oh, they were. When they first started doing it, people were using
when you got this woman with a shocked expression, someone's kidnapped a woman. And they got
that. That was funny. I thought it was kind of funny that people were doing that. I mean, if it worked.
It worked.
But it ain't going to work forever. Eventually, they're going to go, that's a dummy in that car. You're going to get pulled over.
And they go, which one, the driver or the passenger?
Yeah, right. So, yeah.
But, when you did Salacious Crumb, what was it like?
Oh, I did it wild. I did it in the studio in San Rafael. It was just me and Ben Burt and I. He described the character and kind of described scenes, but not really scenes from the movie, just things that would get emotions that he was looking for. It was about a half hour of doing cackles and gibberish and different sounds. And then he found a good, 20 seconds that he used in the movie. And he cut it to picture, made it fit. So I didn't have to make it fit or anything. It was fun.
How about the Gremlins? Did you have to make those?
Gremlins I did to picture. So we did that to picture. So yeah, it was good. It was fun. I mean, it was improvising. It was all improv. Obviously, you can't really script what a Gremlin says.
No, they're all.
And we would just try stuff, and basically, if it got a laugh from the people in the crew and the other actors I was there with, Howie and Frank, and then you know it's good. You're like, okay, good. Let's move on to the next
Especially
Gremlin.
Especially when you got Harry Mandel, you got to make
making Howie
natural
laugh.
Natural comedian.
That's
back when comedians could get away with stuff.
Right. So yeah, that was good. I'm really happy that it's people still love it. What? Gremlins will be 40 years old next year.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's amazing
and
to me.
It took nearly 30 years for people to actually catch on and want toys.
Yeah, but the toys have been really popular. They just keep coming out with toys every month or few a year they come out with.
So this year they came out with dressier Gremlin sets.
Yes, yeah.
I was surprised. It's all the costumes from Gremlins 2
right.
in the bar.
Right.
As a box that you could dress all the Gremlins up in those different costumes now.
So yeah, so it's been, I've had a great life. I've had a great career. And yeah, I'm thankful, you know.
How was it working with George Romero?
George, I was in the theater with, well, I'd say theater, on an ADR stage. He was very laid back, very, you know, easygoing. You know, there wasn't a lot. It was like, there's a zombie. What do we think it should sound like? And I didn't, you know what I do. And,
all the gurgling.
Yeah, all the gurgling and just make it fit. You know, he's like, that's great. Yeah.
You feel you influenced the Walking Dead zombie sounds?
Probably I did. I mean, they sound like me. They sound like the stuff I did. I guess I did.
Did you ever expect that to happen?
The Walking Dead? Or
no,
a TV series about
series
zombies?
The series to imitate you.
Oh. No, I don't think about those things.
Okay.
You know, I kind of live in my own little world. I don't know.
With your gremlin over there.
Yeah, with my gremlin. Yeah, you don't really think about it, but I did, doing conventions, I did have a lot of the Walking Dead actors would come and be like, you need to do some stuff on Walking Dead, you know, just to kind of Easter egg kind of stuff. And I'd always tell them, I'm like, well, tell them to get a hold of me. They never did, so.
Yeah, it's kind of like when I interviewed Lord Zedd, he was talking about how the voice actor for him, he thinks he influenced Batman's voice in the Christian Bale version.
Christian Bale's?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because
yeah,
one of his monsters he had done, it used the exact same voice.
Well, you'd have to ask Christian, because I'm sure he'd be honest. He's like,
yeah,
I actually did hear that and thought it'd be good for a Batman.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah.
Even though it's funny is when you listen to, sorry about keeping you high.
That's okay, but yeah, we're going to wrap it up here.
Conway talking about his Batman that he did, he just came up with it on the fly.
Yeah.
Yeah. That he realized that Batman had to have a deeper voice, a barrel.
Well, yeah, than the one, what worked for the original TV series, that was very campy, but I mean,
that's what they were shooting for,
it was supposed to be very campy, and, but Adam West was perfect, he was perfect for that.
And him and Burt Ward played off of each other real nice.
Yeah, they did, they were great.
Yeah, they were.
But he had a deep voice, I mean, he didn't have a high voice.
And he never overshadowed the guests, and they were the ones who were showcased, the villains.
Right. Yeah, it was more fun and kind of good.
They loved having Burgess Meredith on the show.
I love Burgess Meredith. He's my favorite. The Penguin, because
I enjoyed
love
the
Burgess
Riddler.
Meredith. Frank the Riddler, Gorshin. Frank Gorshin. I love Frank Gorshin. He was a great voice actor. And
you know, the way he put that laugh into it, they made up for it.
Yeah. No, Frank Gorshin was great. Cesar Romero was great.
The man who refused to shave his mustache.
Yeah, Cesar Romero was great. As the Joker,
and Julie
I thought.
Newmar, made the Catwoman iconic.
Right. Yep.
But yeah, I better let you go since you said you had to pack up.
I'm ready to pack up.
Thank you for doing the interview in the last few minutes.
Yeah, you bet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
No problem.
All right.